travel. The idea of making boats must have occurred when people saw logs of wood floating on water. So they also realized that a boat should be made in a shape of fish so that they could travel faster. The invention of the wheel brought about a revolution in transport. The design of the wheel was improved over thousands of years. Later, the animal power was replaced by engine power. Some measurements. Now, how do we start in with the process of measurement? Let us work in a group. And each of you use your hand span with your hand as a unit to measure the width of your desk. Recall all the observations. So we have to measure the width of the desk with the help of our hands. So this is called hand span. Okay, so what do you observe? We see that the measurements, whenever we observe that there are 10 number of people, so they have measured using their hand. So you might have observed the measurements are slightly different. Each one of us have a slightly different measurement. So why is it so? See, we see that the measurement means the comparison of an unknown quantity with some known quantity. This fixed unit is known as, unit. So are all the measurements done by either handspan or by foot? Are they all equal? We see that measurement done by handspan or foot might vary. Therefore, some standard unit of measurement are needed which do not change from person to person. In ancient India, small length measurements were done by finger or by fist. Many such body parts were used as a unit of length. However, everyone's body part that is being used could be slightly different in size, which caused confusion. And hence, the French created a standard unit of measurement called metric system. Now, correct measurement of length. Now, later on, the metric system was introduced, which had meters, centimeters, kilometers. So now we had a fixed standard unit of measurement. Now, how to use like the correct measurement of length? Hold the scale properly along the length of the object. We should always start the measurement from zero mark. Now, if the scale is broken, we can take the measurement from the next full mark and therefore subtract that number from the reading to get the actual length. Like if you start the measurement by 1 centimeter, so whatever the measurement you get, so you can subtract this 1 centimeter from there to get the actual length. The position of eye should be exactly in front of the point of measurement. So these are some correct, like the way you can do the correct measurement of length. Now how to measure the length of a curve? This was for a straight line. But what about a curve? So name the curve line AB. Take a thread and put a knot on one end of the thread. Move the thread along the curve line till the point B and make the mark on the thread. Place the knot on point A of a curved line. Now measure the length of a curved line with a scale. So you can elongate the thread and then measure the length of the curve with a scale. Motion and its time. First of all, what is motion? Motion is a change in the position of an object with time. So with time, when we change the position, this is known as motion. Whereas rest, when something does not change its position with time, is known as rest. Now we have different types of motions. First is rectilinear motion. So it is a motion in a straight line. For example, soldiers marching in a straight line. So this is rectilinear motion. Next we have a circular motion. So when an object moves along a curved path, like if we are moving in a car and we take a curve, we take a left side, so that is a circular motion. Now periodic motion, repetitive motion that repeats itself with a regular interval of time. So now it is repeating again and again with a regular interval of time, is known as periodic motion. So like a pendulum, we can say it's an example of periodic motion. Rotational motion, a motion of an object where the object moves around its axis and in a given time. It is written